Hello, I'm Helen Bradley. Welcome to this video tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can create a scribble text effect in Adobe Illustrator. Before we get started with this video tutorial, let's look and see what it is that we're aiming at. Here is the scribble text that we're going to create in Illustrator, and not only can we use it in Illustrator, but it is also possible for us to bring it into Photoshop as a vector smart object so that we can use it inside our Photoshop designs. It is editable text inside Photoshop. In other words, we're bringing it in as a smart object so we can take it back to Illustrator where we can change the scribble effect, we can change the text, we can change the color, we can change whatever we like. But we're going to start in Illustrator. To create my text, I have a new document in Illustrator. I'm going to choose the text tool. I've chosen a font and a font size of about 300 points because I need some fairly large text. I'm going to type the word and it needs to be sized down a little bit, so I'm going to select it and then click in the size box, and I can just press the down arrow key or shift down arrow to size the text. So once it's been sized, I'm ready to go ahead and create the scribble effect, but I think I'm going to change the color of the font before I do so. So I'm just going to get a red color, and so that we can see how a stroke would appear in this technique, I'm also going to add a smallish sort of stroke, but we can remove that in a minute if we don't like it. So now that I have my text created, we're ready to create the scribble effect, and we do that using effect and then stylize and then scribble. It really is this easy. So I'm going to turn preview on so we can see the effect, and this is the default scribble effect. If we were to disable this stroke color, then we would just be seeing the pink scribble, but you can see that not only the stroke but also the insides of the text are being scribbled. There are a number of different scribble tools that you can use, so you can choose these settings here like dense or childlike or, for example, tight. And if you sort of like an effect but you want to fix it a little bit, you can do so. For example, let's loosen up the spacing a little bit. So I'm just going to tap on spacing there and then use the up arrow key to just space it a little bit wider. And I'll tap on variations and do the same thing. You can drag the slider, but I just find the up arrow key is just a little bit easier to use, especially since we're only adjusting these a really small amount. It's not like we're going all the way to the other end of the slider, because if we do, things are really going to become quite varied, and in terms of spacing, we're just going to wipe out the entire thing. So we only want to work in very small area here. We can also change the angle of the scribble. So I'm just going to add a little bit more curviness to this and perhaps increase the stroke width a little bit and loosen up the spacing just so I have something that is a little bit interesting. Maybe change the angle here. So I'm just going to click OK. And now if I want to, I can remove the border, the stroke from this, so I'll click on the shape and I'll just remove the stroke. So now I have my text and I want to put this into Photoshop, so I'm going to select the text here and choose edit and then copy, and I'm going to swing across to Photoshop, and here is my image. I'm just going to get rid of that vector object and we're going to add a new one. So I'm going to just paste the vector object into position. So I'll do edit and then paste special paste in place. And this allows me to paste it as a smart object, which I'm going to do, and I'll click OK. Now the reason for pasting it as a smart object is that it is still editable in Illustrator. But for now, I'm just going to add a drop shadow to this so that we can see the text a little bit more clearly. So I'm just going to wind up the spread on the drop shadow and go OK. So I'm looking at this now and thinking it might be a bit better if the text were yellow. So I'll go back to my Vector Smart object and double click this icon here. This will then take me back to Illustrator. I can reselect my text in Illustrator and choose a different color for it. I'll go to Window and then Swatches. Oh, here's my swatches palette over here. I'm just going to create a color, so I'll click for a new color and I'm just going to create my color here and click OK. Now my text is updated, so I can just close this and make sure I save it, because this is the VectorSmart object inside the Photoshop document. It's different to the original vector object, which I still have inside Illustrator. Now let's go back to Photoshop, and you can see that the text has been updated. So we can bring in live updatable text into Photoshop, the scribble text effect from Illustrator. Not only is the color of the text editable, but also the text itself would be editable. So if we wanted to change it to change the word, we could do it as easily as we did change the color. I'm Helen Bradley. Thank you for joining me for this video tutorial. Look out for more tutorials like this on my YouTube channel, and visit projectwoman.com for more tips, tricks, and tutorials on Photoshop, Lightroom, Illustrator, and a whole lot more.